Hi guys, welcome to WebSensePro, welcome to another video. So in this video, I'll show you guys how you can use Shopify Flow to automate your Shopify store, which will remove a lot of repetitive tasks from your day-to-day Shopify store management. So one case scenario is that if you have a product which goes out of stock, you don't have to manually check it. It will automatically notify you to your Slack channel, to your email. If you have Asana, you can add Asana integration. It's basically like a Zapier, but within the Shopify. You don't need any third-party paid app for that. You can simply do that everything within the Shopify using the Shopify Flow app. So it empowers you to build custom automation that help you run your business more efficiently, and all of that without needing to learn any code. Yes, you don't need to learn any code in order to automate your day-to-day processes. It's all drag and drop, and you can simply add in logic of your own that if something happens, then it will trigger that specific action. So in this video, I'll give you a basic overview of how you can install Shopify Flow and how you can automate a scenario where if product goes less than 5 in stock quantity, it will automatically notify you on your Slack channel and on your email. So if you want to learn how you can do this, stick to the video and don't forget to subscribe the channel if you want to learn how to optimize your Shopify store to the maximum level and increase the store conversions. So without further ado, let's get into the screen. So guys, as you can see my screen, that's the app which we'll be using. The app name is Shopify Flow, as I told you guys, and it's really helpful to automate your store with hundreds of example templates for popular use cases. So this app already have hundreds of example templates which you can use to automate your workflow and avoid the repetitive tasks. Also, you can add your own conditional logic and as many actions as you need. You can add condition based on tags, on meta fields, on fulfillment, and you can automate with a lot of apps, for example, Slack, Google Sheets, and more. It was previously launched for only Shopify Plus stores, but now it's available for Shopify Basic as well. Now let's install that app and try to create a basic customer workflow, which will automatically check the quantity of a variant and then notify us on our Slack channel, right? So let's install that app and click on install button here. And our Shopify Flow app has been installed. Now let's check out some of the featured templates. So click on see all templates. And here we have capture payment if order is not high fraud risk. So if you're getting a lot of orders and you are manually checking if the order is high risk or low risk, you can automate this by using this automation. And that's the template for get notified by email when product variant is low. So basically I'll be creating this template from scratch to show you guys how you can create your own custom workflows, and it will notify you via your Slack channel. So, and a lot of different type of templates available: payment reminder sent on due dates, cancel and restock high risk orders. So one of the biggest issue with the big stores is that they have to cancel the orders manually when the order is high risk. So they got order like $50,000+ order, just a fake order in order to get your attention divert or whatever your competitor is doing, it might be doing. You can simply automate this by canceling those order and restock those products by having this automation. So now let's start creating our own custom automation, in which we'll first check if the product is less than 5 in quantity, and then it will automatically notify us on our Slack channel, right? So let's first go to the products and see. We have some products, and what we will do is that we will add a test order for this one, and when it goes less than 5 in item, it will automatically send us the message in our Slack. Okay, so let's go back to our Shopify Flow app. And now let's create a workflow. Click on create workflow. Click on select a trigger. And let's search for product, variant, item. So that's the trigger which we will add: product, variant, inventory, quantity change. So when someone orders, it will, or Shopify automatically removes it from the quantity, which is automated. We will add the trigger when quantity is less than 5, it will automatically send us a Slack message. So let's add product, variant, inventory, quantity change. And I'm going to name this workflow notify via Slack if product variant is less than 5. Okay. And now click on then. Now we will add a condition that it should be less than 5, right? So click on condition and let's search for the conditions. We can also add multiple conditions. So in here, we can add multiple condition and it will check if those conditions are true. And if those conditions are true, it will then go to action, which we will add later, right? So click on add criteria and we will search for product, variant, quantity. So it should be within product variant. And let's search for product inventory quantity. So it will check product variant inventory quantity less than. So if inventory quantity is less than 5, then we will add an action. So let's add an action. Click on then. Now we don't need any conditions because we have added a condition to check product variant inventory quantity is less than 5. Click on action. Now action which we'll perform is sending a Slack message, right? So let's first remove this here where it will show all of the apps where we can add automation. So you can see we have a lot of different apps through which we can add actions. So product reviews, AKO marketing, a lot of different apps. We also have Asana. So if you want to add an Asana task to your supplier, to your vendor, that they'll send you those items so you can restock those items, you can do that as well. For now, we will send a Slack message. So let's search for Slack and send a Slack message. Click on send Slack message. Now it's giving you an error because we'll have to connect our Slack with Shopify Flow. And now click on install. Okay, now I'm already logged into my Slack workspace. You should also be logged into your Slack workspace. After logging in, click on this install button here and then click on allow. Okay, now our Slack is connected with Flow. Cool. I'm gonna close this window and let's refresh. So it's asking us to refresh, click on refresh. And now we will create a new channel in Slack and add our channel ID here, right? So let's go to Slack. I'm going to create a new channel. So click create channel in Slack. I'm going to name this channel Shopify Automation Test and then create a channel. Perfect. You can add member of your team in this Slack channel so they all will be notified when a product goes less than 5. Okay, I'm going to skip this for now. Now we have created a channel. Now we will add our Shopify Flow bot in Slack by mentioning that by add, and then Shopify Flow, it should be Flow. And now hit enter. And then it's asking you, do you want to add Flow bot on this channel? Yes, I want to add Flow bot to this channel. Click on add to channel, and our Shopify automation test channel is now connected with the Flow bot by Shopify, right? Now in Shopify Flow automation, it's asking for channel or member ID. You can also send message to a specific person, but in this case, we are sending a message to a whole channel. Okay, now I'm going to add my channel ID, which is this here. So I'm going to copy this here and then paste it following hash sign. Okay, now we will create a message that if a product goes less than 5, send this message. Now I'm going to type in a message, hi team. Now I want a dynamic product name. So with the product which is going less than 5, it will show the same name of that product, which is dynamically updated every time, right? So I'm going to add a variable, click on add a variable. And here we will search for product variant name. And here's product variant. And in here we will search for name. Product variant name. I think we messed it up. Okay, here it is. So it will display name of the variant based on product's title plus variant title. Okay, I want that. So hi team, this product is low in stock only. Now I'm going to add a dynamic variable for adding the actual quantity of that product, right? Click on add a variable, click on product variant, and now I'm going to search here the quantity inventory. So here is the inventory quantity, which will tell us the remaining quantity of that specific variant. Click on that. And now it's saying that, hi team, this product is low in stock, only this is left. Please restock. Thanks. So that's the Slack message, which will be automatically received when the product goes less than 5, right? So let's turn on the workflow. Okay, now our workflow is turned on and active. Now we will add a test order for this product and we'll make it. So currently it's 10 in stock. By adding 6 item in order, we'll have it less than 4, and it should automatically shoots a notification to our Slack channel here. Okay. Now let's place a test order. And which product was that? Okay. Classic leather wireless charger. I'm going to add 6 item on the cart. Place a test order. Okay, click on pay now. Oops. Okay, our order is placed, and now you can see we have automatically this notification showing up. Hi team, this drop classic leather wireless charger default title is low in stock. Only 4 is left, please restock. So it's automatically sending a text message, a notification to our Shopify automation test channel, which we created once this product goes low in stock. So if I refresh here on my product screen, you can see that we have 4 in stock, and it has automatically sent a notification to our Slack channel. Now you can also add multiple actions. So we have this trigger here, and this is a condition logic, and this is an action. So these are the 3 steps through which you can create your custom workflows. You can have multiple condition logics as well. So if I click on this plus sign here and click on add condition here, you can add another condition and add in your criterias. You can also add multiple criterias within one condition. So this is one criteria. You can add another criteria by adding this add criteria, and I don't need that for now. So it was just to show you guys. And you can also add multiple actions. In one action, we sent a Slack message. On another action, so click on this plus sign again and then click on action again. And then what we need is internal email. So you can also send an email to your team, add your email address here, add the subject line here, and similarly create the text message by adding the variables. You can also add variables within the subject line and automate this workflow. If you have an assistant or someone who is doing manually stock checking, then you can completely get rid of those manual tasks and automate your workflow by this Shopify Flow app. And that's a pretty cool app basically. So that's it for the video, guys. I wanted to show you the basic overview of how Shopify Flow works. If you like the video, don't forget to let me know in the comments below. Also, there's a limited time offer if you are new to Shopify and you want to sign up to your Shopify store with just $1 a month. Link in the description. If you sign up using that link, you will get free 3-day trial and a $1 per month Shopify new store. If you're a new store owner, check out the link and sign up through that. Until next video, have a great day.